Okay, this is probably my most requested video, so hopefully I can get through it and explain it really well, but this is going to be how to make a daily sub goal. Okay, yeah, not gonna lie, daily sub goals are pretty complicated to set up at first. It's hard to figure out, and it took me so long to figure out how people got these cool daily sub goals that were just numbers on their screen, and they would increment anytime somebody gifted a sub or just subscribed to them. And I was always like, I wonder how you can set it up. But today I'm going to explain it to you guys, so hopefully I can make it easier for you guys so you guys don't have to spend like a week trying to figure this whole thing out. So first, I'm gonna go start with how to add it in Streamlabs OBS, and then I'm gonna explain how to add it in OBS. So here we are in Streamlabs OBS. This Streamlabs OBS is actually hooked up or linked to my alternate account that I use to make examples with. I just have one account that I like to use when I'm making examples on like how to set up a new stream or something like that. So this is the account. So I'm just using a blank scene that has absolutely nothing in it. So all we're gonna add is the daily sub goal. So we wanna go hit plus, and then if we under widgets scroll down, there should be something called stream label. So we wanna click that and hit add source. And we can name it whatever we want. I'll just call it daily sub goal, and we're gonna hit add source. Now, this is where it gets a little bit interesting. So under label type, we want to go and look for something that says session subscriber count. Now, you can do this with anything. So you can make like an incrementing follow goal, an incrementing donation goal. Like by incrementing, I mean like as numbers. So it will say like maybe like, 69 out of 70 followers or something like that, instead of having it as a bar. So all of these would come out as numbers. So we're just gonna scroll till we find, oh, here we go, session subscriber count. This is what it will look like. It will just be some random little number in the corner, but we're gonna go and make it look more interesting. Okay, so under our sources, we wanna double click this daily sub goal. You can check whether you'd like to include a resubs or not. I just always keep this checked. Now, here is the label template. It is a squiggly bracket count. This will just like randomly give you this will give you the number of subscribers you had in that session. But to set a sub goal, like a number you wanna hit, you can type slash and then whatever number you would like. So if you want like three, your daily sub goal is three. If your daily sub goal is five, my personal daily sub goal is 20. So I'm just gonna leave it at that. And the way this works is any number you type after the squiggly bracket will not change unless you change it within the label template. So no matter how many subs I get or whatever, the slash 20 will still stay like that. But the squiggly bracket counts. Well, it refers to the zero because this session I have zero subs, and well, this account is not even affiliate, so you can't even get subs. But if it were to get subscribers, it would count upwards. Now, we can go and change the font so you can find a different font in the font family. It will pick from your computer. But you can also check use Google Fonts if you would like to use Google Fonts as well. So I'm just gonna go and look for a font that I like that I think looks really good. So I don't know, we're just gonna randomly pick this font. I really like this font. You can change the font style, whether you like to make it bold or not. This particular font doesn't have a different option. And we can make it bigger or not. I'm just gonna make it really big for the sake of examples. So we're gonna make it 144. Now you can see it changing live. You can also change the color of the text. So let me see here. I want to go and make it pink. And then we could also add a gradient as well. I also like adding gradients. It makes it look nice. So we can click this. Let me go select maybe like a yellow. You can change the opacity of the gradient, whether you want to make it dimmer or not. You can change the direction of the gradient. So it's up to you as to whether you'd like to do that. The background just adds a box behind it, up to you if you'd like to do that. I high key recommend adding an outline just so that it makes the text easier to see. And you can change the outline thickness here, so we can make it like a 10 or something like that. And that looks really good. So we're gonna hit done. Now, here is our daily sub goal. It's already done, kind of. But what we also want to add is text that will refer to this and say daily sub goal, because otherwise you're gonna be like 0 out of 20. What the hell is that? Like, what is the 20? I have no idea. Like, is this a follower goal, a sub goal, a dono goal? I have no idea. We want to let people know. So hit plus again, and then we're gonna go under text and we're gonna add source. I'm just gonna name this like daily sub goal text. Name it whatever you want, but it'll just be the text for it. And then over here under text, we can type daily sub goal like this. And then again, make sure that you keep everything consistent, so you keep the formatting and everything the same. So we're just gonna kind of do that and just mess around with it until it matches. All right, here we go. Now I have the text that matches the daily sub goal. Okay, let me just make it a little bit smaller. I think I might have made it too obnoxiously large. There is the daily sub goal for your stream in Streamlabs OBS. And again, you can do this with whatever. You can do it as a daily sub goal, a daily follower, like, or no one really does a daily follower goal, but like a follower goal, a donut goal, etc., etc. And now I'm gonna go and show you how to do this in OBS. So if you want to do this in OBS, it's a lot more complicated, but it's still doable. So we're gonna go under Streamlabs, and then we're gonna search for stream labels, and it should be the first link that comes up. Hit enter. Let's close this, and now you want to go and download stream labels for your computer and follow the download instructions. I've already downloaded it, so I would have to uninstall it just to reinstall it, and it's gonna mess up all my settings. So kind of don't want to do that. But again, like, you just go and over here, click whichever operating system you have to go download it on. So I have Windows, so I would just do it for that. And one thing to take into account, when you download stream labels, it will ask you to make a folder. Make sure you can find this folder, because it's actually really important. You want to make sure it's like easy to find. Don't hide it under like 6 bajillion folders and lose it. But once you get it downloaded, it should look something like this. Once you have it downloaded right here, you will have your little stream labels program from Streamlabs. Now, in order for your stream labels to automatically increment, so that like if you get a sub during stream, it would count upwards from 0 to 1, you must keep this program open as you are streaming. I know it's a little bit frustrating, but you must do this in order for it to work. Also, one other thing, go to your alert box, scroll down, and then under reset stream labels, stream label session automatically, you want to make sure it is enabled. And then don't forget to save settings once you changed it. If it's not enabled, your stream labels will also not automatically increment. So you must do both. You must reset your stream label session automatically in your alert box settings under Streamlabs, and also keep stream labels open. So now we go under settings here, and then I already have it on session subscriber counts, but we want to go look for the session subscriber count. So we're going to scroll till we find it, and then, you know, here we go, it's already here. Now, the session subscriber count will it will show you a number like this. It will just look like the squiggly bracket count. If you watched my explanation on how to do it for Streamlabs OBS, same thing. It will only give you the squiggly bracket count. Now, if you have a goal for your daily sub goal or whatever, let's say it's like daily sub goal of 3, 5, whatever, type slash and whatever that number is. So my daily sub goal is 20, so I'm gonna leave it at that right here. We're gonna do the slash 20. And again, this number will not change. So when you get a subscriber, the squiggly bracket count, it's a variable, and it will pull the number of subscribers you got per that session. So if you start a stream, it'll be at a 0. But if you got a sub, it'll be a 1. So that number will change from 0 to 1, but your slash 20 number will not change, no matter how many subs you get. It will stay the same. So we're just gonna type it at that, whatever your daily sub goal is, hit save settings, and then you can just cancel. We'll just because it to cancel takes you back to the home page. I don't know why it says cancel. I don't know why there's no back option, but that is what it is. So that is the case, and then we're gonna go to OBS, and hopefully I can show you this without bugging everything out. Okay, so here's my OBS, and there's like a ton of me's like doubling up, and I know it looks really random and trippy, but we're gonna work with it. I'm sorry, I've never been able to figure out how to go and screen share you guys my OBS without everything like doubling up like this. Okay, but this is like my hypothetical temporary like how I record my stream for YouTube. So we're gonna hit plus. And then we're gonna go add text, like daily sub goal 3000, okay, 3 bajillion. This is what I mean by you want to make sure you can find your file. So we over here in this box, we're gonna check read from file, and then we're gonna browse for our folder that will have the stream labels in it. When you downloaded stream labels, it asks you to make a folder. We're gonna look for that folder right here. So I have it saved under stream labels outputs, and we're just gonna go scroll and find session subscriber count. So right here, session subscriber count, we're gonna hit open, and here it would read from your file that has the session subscriber count. So the number will automatically increment as you get more subs. And I have not reset this number. So I got 9 subs last stream. So it would leave it still currently says the 9 until I choose to reset it. Now again, we can go and change the font and change it to something that you like. So let me just randomly find. Let me go try to find the font that I used for the other example for Streamlabs. We're gonna do this. Let's make it, well, I'll make it big for the sake of example. So we're gonna leave it like that. We can also change the color. So, maybe something not as obnoxious potentially. We can also add a gradient. If you just check this gradient box here, let's select a color. Let me try to make the same warm sunset that I made for the other example. We can also change the direction of the gradient and add an outline. I high key recommend everybody add an outline for these things so it's easier to see on your screen and hit OK. And now look, we have a number. So this is our daily sub goal that we have. So I'm just gonna go and, like, I don't know, slap it somewhere where it's not, hopefully not weirdly doubling up. Also, hi GM, I see that you sent a message here. And then again, one other thing we want to do is to add text so that you know that this is referring to a daily sub goal and not like a follower goal or something like that, or a donut goal. So hit plus again, add text, and then we can just like daily sub goal text. Oh, I already have a 3000. Okay, we're gonna hit okay. And then let's add the text like daily sub goal. And again, we're gonna go and reformat the font so that it fits nicely. Okay, I wasn't too far off with the colors. So right here we have a daily sub goal text to let you know that it's a daily sub goal, and then we also have our actual numerical goal. Every time you start your stream, you have to hit this button that says restart session, and that will reset your sub goal from whatever that number was back down to 0 for that stream. It's really unfortunate that it doesn't automatically do this every time you go live, but it is what it is. So this is what you have to do every time you go live. And you have to keep stream labels open. But yeah, hopefully you found this video helpful. It's hard for me to try to explain how to do this because screen sharing my OBS, because I record my screen using OBS, is a little bit difficult. But hopefully it was really helpful. Since so many people asking about this, I really just wanted to make a video about this. But if you like this video, please like and subscribe. And don't forget to check me out on Twitch because I do stream on there 5 days a week. I am a full-time content creator now, which has its own like perks and also like funny things. But again, I hope to see you guys in the next video. Peace.